Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Fallout 3. My name is Phil the Conquistadork. I am your host. Didn't do so well in my XCOM playthrough, as you may have known by now, so I needed a little cheering up. And there's no game that cheers me up more than Fallout 3. I absolutely adore this game. It's the first game I ever got 100% completion on for my Xbox 360, so now we're going to play it on the PC. In anticipation of this fall/winter's release of Fallout 4. Hopefully they won't change their tune and have to push it back. Although, let's face facts, if they've got to push it back and it's for the right reasons, I'm good with that. We don't need another fucking, you know, Batman situation on our hands where we buy it and we can't play it for another 4 years. So, I skipped through the tutorial stuff. I skipped through the first basic part of the game, because I figured that would be boring for you. I tend to play kind of a more sneaky, lockpicky, talky guy. I'm definitely going to be upping the speech in this, too, because I think in a Let's Play, the dialogue options will make for a more entertaining and interesting game. That's just the way I see it, though. We are on our way out of the vault right now. Things are getting real, if you will. The shit has hit the fan. We're about to find out what's going on. Let's face it, vault life sucks. So we're gonna beat feet. We're gonna take a powder, get the fuck out of here. All right, what's wrong, Amata?
You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you.
My dad is gone.
He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy.
That's no great surprise. Dad couldn't have really left the vault. That's impossible.
I thought so too, but it's true. He's gone, and Jonas is dead, and now they're looking for you.
Jonas is dead?
My father's men think Jonas helped your dad escape. They caught him and brought him to my dad's office, and they... Oh my god. Yeah, don't worry about me.
I won't.
I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute.
Okay, I can't stay here. Where can I go?
I'm sorry, but I think you'll have to follow your dad. You'll have to escape from the vault. Listen, maybe it isn't any of my business, but didn't your dad tell you that he was leaving?
Nope.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter.
He's dead.
I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen. There's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in.
Lovely, bobby pins. Sounds like a good plan.
Oh,
let's get out.
One more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case.
Thanks.
Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit.
I'm
watch
shoot
out
your
for
dad
security.
In the fucking head
good
if
luck.
I have to. All right.
I'll meet you at the vault room
stuff.
If I can, but don't wait for me.
It's good to take basically everything that isn't nailed to the fucking floor, no matter how dumb the item is, just because you can sell it afterwards and have some valuable caps. Sneaky shoes on. I already got the medicine bobblehead in here, so before any of you point that out, we're all set on that end. See, there it is. Collect. Got a baseball cap. Got a pistola.
There he is. Hold it right there.
All right, Kendall. I'm afraid you're going to have to die. Getting between me and the miraculous beauty that is the wasteland. But I will take your security armor. Oh! Okay. I've been awake for 5 minutes. I've killed 3 rad roaches and I've blown off a human being's head. Clearly, I'm the hero of this story.
Do not interfere with vault security personnel. Any resident found outside...
You gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rad roaches!
Oh, Butch. I'm only gonna help you because I want your leather jacket.
Yeah. Look, I'm sorry for the way I've always treated you. You know I never meant any of it, right?
I do not know
that. But
it's
my mom. You can't leave her in there with the rad roaches.
All right. I'll help. But I'm doing this for your mom, not for you.
Sure. I don't care why.
She's giving me so many wonderful nights. That's right. I'm about 5 minutes in, and I've already made my first your mom joke.
What's happening?
I forgot how awful she sounds. What's happening? Who's talking?
What's happening?
Vodka. Gaining some karma. I do tend to play...
We did it!
...the good
My
guy.
My mom's gonna be okay!
Just so you know.
You're the best friend I've ever had, man. Hey, I know it isn't much, but I want you to have my Tunnel Snake's jacket. Go ahead, take it.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm the kind of guy... I can't even pretend to be a bad guy. I just end up feeling too fucking guilty... choosing. I was that way with Knights of the Old Republic. I was that way with Fallout. I was that way with Mass Effect. I just feel guilty for choosing the bad options. And I always play through both ways, but if I'm just hanging out, if I've just got my druthers, I'm gonna play the good guy. So, if it's disappointing to anyone, I apologize. Steadily running out of ammo, but fortunately, I've got a baseball bat. Always a sound investment. Thanks for the clothing. Now, I don't plan on us going through every single little mission on this game. I'm also not gonna go straight nothing but main quests, so every now and then we might jump around a little bit here. But if there's a quest or a mission or something like that that you think I absolutely should do and you don't want me to miss, please let me know what it is. And I'll make sure that I get to. Some of them are my favorites too, that aren't fully necessary missions. That is.
Man, I think I got something on my shoe. Won't get away with that.
Okay.
Oh, you're lucky it was me who found you. The others won't be so forgiving.
Yeah, I know.
I don't know what you're up to, and I don't want to know. Just clear out of here, and I'll pretend I never saw you.
I already shot one of your friends in the head. I thought you should know that.
It's a real shame it's come to this. I can't believe what they did to Jonas. Officer Mack was just out of control. But you're a good kid. You didn't do anything to deserve this.
I shot a guy in the
head. Go find your dad, if you can.
I'm a murderer. Like, you might want to... cuff me or nothing? Okay. Well,
me and Andy were in a tight spot.
Gonna go murder the shit out of some other people, I guess.
He loves toasting roaches so much.
Just go back to our quarters.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us.
I'm not gonna let anyone stop you.
It's me, Tom Holden. I've got a lot.
Tom, Bullet Shield Holden. I'm not gonna use a BB gun. I feel like that's probably not gonna work out too well for me.
I'm hit!
I'm just jacked up here. Good deal. Good Officer O'Brien. Security armor. I'll put some of that on later. Some rounds. Poor Tom. Saved your girlfriend, Tom. Ha! You'd be more grateful. Whatever. Sneaky, sneaky. There is something really satisfying about that. I also invested in some science because I like hacking the computers.
Oh.
And again, I find that to be a way more interesting way of going through the game. So, my combat stuff isn't always the highest. And don't get me wrong, there are times when I absolutely wish it was higher.
You! This is your fault! You and your stupid father!
Fuck you, I'll come back for you later. Yeah. But I think it makes for a more interesting game, so. I'll fuck you. Alright, Hannon. I crippled your head. You crippled the rest of you. Oh, yeah! Slugger. I am a fucking monster. Of course, he started it, to be fair. I just slaughtered my way through this fucking place. I don't know. I suppose for a guy who talks about how much I like the sneaky game, maybe there's a way for me to sneak around these guys. I've never tried. I just go straight into the splatty-splatty. Despite the fact that I always play a good guy. Hi, Officer Mac. This is nothing personal.
Yeah! Yeah!
Or maybe it is. I don't even know. Fuck off.
Harder on yourself. I hope you're here to turn yourself in, young man.
Turn myself
you're
into
You're already
a
in
monster.
Enough trouble as it is. Don't make it worse for yourself.
Let me see. Give me the keys to your office and your password.
Oh, is that all? Is there anything else I can get you while you're here?
A pita pocket.
You'll get nothing from me. I'll die before I see the safety of the vault compromised again.
Oh, that's fucked up. Yeah, see, I would feel completely and utterly horrible for you choosing that. I'll escape without your help, then. I'm not the one who started killing people.
Save your sanctimony. The world is a dangerous place, and I make no apologies for doing whatever it takes to keep the vault safe. Guards, help me!
I just killed your guard. That's, kinda done. And I pickpocket.
He's here!
Him.
Don't let...
Takes
let him get away!
Money. Let's see what else there is. I feel like there's something else. Yeah, I played Thieves and Rogues all the way back to my first games of D&D when I was a little kid. Those are habits that die pretty hard. I don't need to do that.
He's here! Don't let him get away!
Fuck off. I'm not gonna kill him. Because I have to come back later, and I feel like that makes it more... There's more drama that I need if I killed him. Because Amanda's kind of my girlfriend, and that's her dad. And I know we all want to kill our girlfriend's dads, like, quietly. Maybe that's just me. Poor Jonas. Looks so peaceful. Except for all the blood, that is.
Hold on, Jonas. I need to record this first. I don't really know how to tell you this. I hope you'll understand, but I know you might be angry. I thought about it for a long time, but in the end, I decided it was best for you not to know. So many things could have gone wrong, and there's really no telling how the Overseer will react when he finds out. It's best if he can blame everything on me. Obviously, you already know that I'm gone. It was something I needed to do. You're an adult now. You're ready to be on your own. Maybe someday things will change and we can see each other again. I can't tell you why I left or where I'm going. I don't want you to follow me. God knows life in the vault isn't perfect, but at least you'll be safe. Just knowing that will be enough to keep me going.
Don't mean to rush you, Doc, but I'd feel better if we got this over with.
Okay, go ahead. Goodbye. I love you.
That is a nice touch when they put in those audio logs.
Thank you! I told you my father wasn't himself. I don't know what he might have done if you hadn't come along. You'd better get out of here. I'll try to meet you at the vault door. If I don't make it, good luck.
Now that's one thing, because I do come back to him, and I wonder if there's a way I can actually make the romance situation between her and him happen. Because it seems possible, but I'm not sure. I'll have to do some research before I get to that level. That's a while in the future, though. Deus Ex. Services coming in. Oh, using them like the mob, huh? Doesn't get the geck. It comes into play later. Let's open that tunnel. I'm gonna actually. Oh, yeah. Living in the vault sucks. This is really the best thing, we're all concerned. Even if I have to deal with fucking mutant ogre beasts out in the wilderness, and giant ants that spit fire, and crazy power-armored sociopaths with miniguns that... You know, now that I'm saying it out loud, maybe being in the vault isn't... so bad. But still, it'll be a far more boring game. That's a... speaking of boring games, yeah, that's why I had to play this instead of keep... I kept playing Fallout Shelter at first, and that was cute at first, but the more you played it, the more you were like, okay, I think we're done.
He's opening the vault door!
Keep
the door open now!
Open the door! That is so cool.
You did it! You opened the door! My God, I almost didn't believe it was possible.
Come on, girl. Let's run away into the sunset.
No, you didn't need me. If anyone can survive out there, it's you.
Why don't you come with me, girl?
It's tempting, but my place is here. The vault needs me more than you do.
Besides,
I'm the only one who has a chance to talk some sense
on.
Into my father. Listen, if you do catch up with your dad, tell him I'm sorry for you know, Jonas and my father and everything. Goodbye.
Gotcha now.
All right, you dickweeds.
What's the matter, huh?
Yeah! Can't stand the sight of your own blood?
Oh, fuck off.
Ow!
I don't know if you can tell, but I've, set myself up with a very handsome mustache. And, of course, strapping mohawk hairstyle. You can't tell that because of the ball cap. But, I'm very pleased with my look.
Bring it!
Become the Doc Holliday of this land. You guys can get some hot bullets. Ah, that was just enough to put me over the edge, huh? Yeah. I got a lot of junk. I mean, that's a good thing, though. But, excuse me. So we're loaded up.
You've got to get out of here. Someone's sure to come see what's going on.
See you, girl. All right, we're good, ladies and gents. We are heading out into... What a beautiful adventure. Ah. I love this game so fucking much. Every single time you leave the ball, it's such a good feeling. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna up my science a little bit. Because I want that. Hair comes in handy too when I get robots and whatnot. As my XCOM playthrough showed you, I love robots. I'm gonna up my explosives just enough because, well, maybe I should do it more. Because I want to take out the bomb in Megaton. And I always go, I don't know about you guys, but I almost always go with the Swift Learner perk, so first levels are upped quickly. Yeah, every single time I leave the vault, this view, it just holds up so nicely. I came to Fallout 3 late. I played it years after it came out. And the hype machine for it was over at that point. But my god, it still just stuck with me. And a lot of people argue the New Vegas is superior for story reasons and mechanics and that kind of thing. And maybe objectively they're correct to a certain extent, but it just never affected me on the level that Fallout 3 did. It just never did. And maybe it's the East Coast versus West Coast thing. I'm definitely more of an East Coast guy. My god. Just... This was me. This really... Fallout 3 really hits the spot. If when you're looking for just a nice, big adventure. So, I'm excited to be playing this. I'm glad y'all have joined me on this one. And hopefully, we can get this thing closed out and finished before Fallout 4. God, if it takes that long, then clearly done something wrong. But yeah, in anticipation of Fallout 4 coming out, I genuinely can't think of
hey there,
a better way to get started. So, all right, Crow.
Welcome, welcome. My name is Crow, and I travel the land offering vestments of protection. And you are fortunate I found you in time. You bear the look of one who is haunted. But I am proud
right.
to say that my wares can protect you from even the cruel claws of death itself. Have a look.
Okay. What we got?
If the clothes make the man, Then here are the means to remake yourself.
Thing he's got is the main spike armor, which I think is still. Yeah, my security armor is still better than that. I should probably put some of it on, by the way. But whatever. Sell a couple more things and I can get some money. Yeah, this is what I meant when I said earlier, you just gotta sell everything that isn't nailed to the ground.
Another satisfied customer.
Damn right.
Walk well, friend.
So I got some money to start with.
Have yourself a nice visit, partner.
I love Megaton.
Another newcomer. Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too, when the need arises. I don't know why, but I like you, boy.
Probably
something tells me you're
all
right. So welcome to Megaton. Just holler if you need something.
Next town you got here, Sheriff. Pleasure to meet you.
Friendly and well-mannered.
Yeah, well.
I think we're gonna get along just fine. You treat my people nice, and you're welcome to stay as long as you'd like.
Right. Message received.
I'm glad we understand each other. Now, is there something I can help you with?
Looking for my dad. Middle-aged guy. Looks a bit like Liam Neeson.
Nope. Sorry. I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't have time to keep tabs on every visitor. I'd ask around town.
Discuss this bomb.
What about it?
You know, the bomb you didn't really bring up. Someone should disarm that thing.
I don't trust any of the locals to tinker with it. Besides, most people don't even realize it's still a threat. And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? Do you think you got the know-how to disarm it? For good?
I can see about it.
Oh, all right. Fine. But listen here. Just take a look at it first. Go easy. If you get the job done, there'll be 100 caps in it for you.
100 caps? Speech is not. Let's try it anyway.
Not an option, I'm afraid. We aren't exactly rolling in cash down here.
I know. All right, I'll take a look.
Great. Go ahead and see what you can do. Just be careful.
Okay.
Good to see you.
He's coming with the clouds. And every...
All right, the right gear. Let's attempt to disarm the bomb. Hey, did it. I'm a hero.
With his glory.
It was easy. Pretty sure I had to have my explosives at 25 for that. So if any of you are planning on doing that...
I'll be damned. You did it, didn't you? You disarmed that thing.
I did.
Here's your reward. Hell, why don't you move in? Could use someone like you. Got an empty place here you can use. Here's the key indeed. It ain't much to look at, but talk with Moira. She's got random odds and ends you might be able to spruce the place up with.
All right, Moira. Helping you maybe look at the dad.
Well, come to think of it, I do remember a stranger coming through here. Look in his eye. You know the kind a man gets when he's got a purpose. Spend some time up in the saloon.
Purpose.
Might want to check with Moriarty.
That's for fans of the jerk out
Just
there.
Watch yourself. That man's trouble.
Okay. I think we're good.
Take care now.
I'm gonna, yeah, I'm gonna love you. lockpick in there. Good. Keep up with the swift. I think I can learn that one up to 3 times. And that just comes in handy. Up on my skills. Alright. Let's check out this new house.
Come forth and drink the waters of
people worshiping an atom bomb. Shot a dude in the face. My character has been awake for roughly half an hour. It's a pretty good day. Hello, Wadsworth.
Allow me to introduce myself. I am Wadsworth, your personal robotic butler. I am here to look after your needs and to keep you happy and entertained. What can I do for you?
Give me some of the drink.
Certainly, sir. Here you are.
Love it. Love it. Tell me a joke.
Ah, do you know the best contraceptive for old people is nudity?
Love it. I think that's Fran Lebowitz who wrote that one. Or, no, that wasn't Fran Lebowitz. Phyllis Diller. It's one of the two. Anyway.
You have yourself a fine day, sir.
I will. Let's put my bobblehead down. Get that little... Maybe I can try to get all of those. That'll be a fun one. Okay. Get some food in the fridge. It's nice to have a well-stocked fridge. Figure it out now. Oh, I love it. It's a fixer-upper, but you know what? It's mine. Quiet and cozy. All right, let's sell some more.
Dears, no sorrows, no suffering. For in the division, we shall see our release from the...
What are you raking exactly? Like... You gonna till the soil there? Is that just the fertile ground you're hoping for? It just doesn't strike me as... Alright. This is some people's favorite character in the whole game, and some people's most hated character in the whole game. And on both counts, you're about to find out why.
Hey! I hear you're that stray from the vault! Oh, I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say, I'm working on a book about the wasteland. It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you?
Oh, you know I will. I got plenty to say, Moira.
Great. Just tell me what it's like to live underground all your life. Or to come outside for the first time, or whatever strikes your fancy.
Let's see. No fear, no worries, no fighting. Until Dad left. The main rock infants. Utopia of a bow before my glory. How do you people live out here? I haven't found a food spot, so anyway. It's cramped, dark, and the food sucked. Good riddance. I'm gonna go with fish out of water. This outside place is amazing.
Yeah, you wouldn't imagine how hard it is to replace that big light bulb up there, too. That's great for a forward. Open with a joke and all that. Here, take the suit. Something tells me you might need it. That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you, and it'll be fun.
Ah, classic. Yes, yes I do.
Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a wasteland survival guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens. No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words.
I can't wait to help. Let's do this. Let's make this miracle
good
happen.
Good enthusiasm!
Uh-huh.
Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, sounds like fun, doesn't it? Which do you want to do first?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is a classic. We're going to go and rummage for
some food.
Well,
food and medicine.
Oh.
Everyone needs them once in a while, right? So they need a good place to find them. There's an old super-duper mart not far from here. I need to know if a place like that still has any food or medicine left in it.
Well, I'll check the super-duper.
Oh, great! Food is most important, but see if you can get medicine, too. And if there's nothing to find, then just come back in one piece, okay?
No promises.
Good to see that old house finally found an owner. I have all sorts of items and themes for that place that may interest you.
And as I recall, they are expensive as fuck.
Sure thing.
All right. Yeah. You got a lot of stuff, girl. It is all very, very expensive. Yeah. All right. Let's just sell off some junk. Yeah, that's what I want. Hang on to that. I'm already recalling a lot of the, recipes, if you will, for a lot of these different items that I can build. So, if any of you are wondering why I'm keeping certain items, it's I'm thinking ahead, I guess, is what I'm getting at. Thinking ahead. See? Get some schematics later on.
Good hunting.
Yeah, thank you. All right, let's put on my clothes. Which is pretty cool, though. Pistol. Okay. All right, so I'll go back to my house. That house. One of the reasons I make sure my explosives and whatnot are high enough to... It's either explosives or repair. It's one of the two.
To
disarm this bomb is because having this house early on is really good. Just as a place to be able to drop off stuff that you don't want to immediately sell. So come here. I go to one of my various lockers. Eventually I like to sort them out because I'm... to store loot in. But before we leave, talk to a couple more people and get some little side missions. For example,
form of this ephemeral
do some
body
repairs around
into
here
new
so
life
can,
in the forge of your
blood. Eventually I'll be able to hold on to scrap metal and sell it.
Yeah, what is it?
Anything I can do?
Well, it's no secret that the old water treatment plant is on its last legs. And I'm the only one in town that can keep the damn thing running.
I love your beard.
I spend so much time up in the plant that I can't take care of the leaks that keep springing up in the pipes around town. Now, I don't expect much from strangers, but if you've got the know-how, I need someone to hunt down and repair those leaks. From the pressure in the plant, my guess is that there are three of them scattered around town.
I just sensed that through my beard.
Check along the pipes and the valves, but they might be a bit tricky to spot.
All right, I'll keep it in mind.
I hope you can help. If folks knew how bad it was getting up here, well, I don't know what would happen.
Neither do I. I gotta go, though. Yeah. Okay, I'm back. Sorry, I had to skip ahead there. My computer was acting all funky, and I needed more coffee. So, heading into Moriarty's saloon.
Yeah, you need something?
Come on, you piece of junk. Every day it's the same thing.
Yes, that's locked.
Colin Moriarty, at your service. Welcome to Moriarty's. My saloon, my home, my slice of heaven in this backwoods little burg.
You've got the caps, Irish bro.
I've got your pleasure. Please sit down, make yourself comfortable. Your troubles are a thing of the past.
Looking for my dad.
My God, it's you. The little baby boy all grown up. Persistent little bastard, ain't you? Then and now, it would seem. It's been a long time, kid. Oh, your daddy passed through here all right. Here and gone. Got what he came for and then left. I'm assuming you'll do the same, correct?
Damn right.
Is that what your father told you? That you were born in that hole? That he was born there as well? Oh, the lies we tell to those we love. Your father brought you to the vault right after you were born. To keep you safe, you see. I remember it well. You stayed in my saloon, after all. That's right. Your father, his brotherhood of steel friend, and you, the suckling babe with nary a tit to suckle. Sorry about your mom, truly. But life goes on. Daddy Lloyd. Life's full of little disappointments. And now you're all grown up and wondering where he's gone to. Ah, I see. You know, I heard about the brainwashing that goes on down there from some other fella escaped, 5 years back. All hail the overseer. We're born in the vault, we die in the vault, and all that other assorted lunacy. Kid, you've got better programming than our own Deputy Weld. You best wise up quick. Wouldn't want anyone taking advantage of you, hmm?
Someone like you, maybe? All right. Speech feeling. Let's try this out. I was kidding. Dad talked about you all the time. Now, really, where is he?
Did he? Well, our time together was brief. But that is the way of it out here. When a bond is forged, little else matters, hmm? Well, he did come through here, but he left. I'm truly sorry. But maybe you can catch up to him. He headed southeast into the city. Said he needed information from those loonies at the station. You know, Galaxy News Radio. What there is of it.
Galaxy News.
Galaxy News Radio is some loudmouth radio station located in the ruins of D.C. Three Dog, the king of that loony bin, keeps yapping about fighting some good fight or something. A bunch of crap. But I suppose if you wanted to know what was going on in the wasteland, that's the place to go. Me, I could care less.
Okay. I gotta go.
I await our next meeting with bated breath.
I'm sure.
And I told you, Gob, it ain't the radio. The Enclave station comes in fine. It's Galaxy News. Their signal's been...
All right, let's see.
Hello?
Hello. All right, we know Dad went over to, Galaxy News Radio. So that's where we're gonna head soon. Oop. Ah, I need to get my repair up to fix that thing. So let's go find some food and medicine. Then we'll do some repairs. Okay, we're gonna do Wasteland Survival Guide for now.
Please help me. I need water. I'm dying.
All
Are you serious? I can't offer anything in exchange, you know. I can just have it. For free?
Least I can do to help.
Really?
You know,
seriously? My God.
They wanted to go really deep.
Thank
they
you.
Could have it that I would ask for
Thank
a
you so much.
Or something like
I'll
that.
Never forget this.
You know, in a world like this, just, you know, it's just like anything else. It's like prison or anything else. Blowjobs are just a staple currency, right up there with cigarettes and gold bullion. You fucker. Oh, I'm so good at shooting. Oh! Bastard. Now I steal your meat. That's what you get. If I'm gonna get that, do they do takedowns for the music that plays on Galaxy News? It just strikes me that it wouldn't be, it's too old to have too big of a copyright infringement on, huh? No, we'll play it every now and then. And frankly, Fallout 3 just isn't Fallout 3 without... Well, I mean, the Fallout series, anyway, starting at Fallout 3, I didn't really do that. Oh, they did. They did in the old ones. But all the same, you know, this series just isn't the series that it is without that odd, old-fashioned jazz and that sort of thing in the background. It really does make the world what it is. So, you're gonna have to have some of that. Good. Being hanged. Love it. Love it.
Those monsters.
Huh?
They're gonna get me.
Oh, you. All right, calm down, dude.
No, those things will get me. I can't. I gotta keep going.
All right, hey, calm down. It's gonna be okay. Promise.
You won't leave me like all the other grown-ups. You can help me.
Sure. Unless it involves murdering giant ants that breathe fire. I'm really no good at that.
Those big things. They're all over Graditch. And they killed everyone. Please, mister. Please find my papa.
Find your papa. Alright.
You will?
Sure.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Thanks a whole lot.
You're welcome.
My house is the one closest to the huge sign and the old diner. Please, find my papa and make him come back.
I'll make it. Look, anything else you can do to help might save lives.
You know, maybe this will help, and maybe it won't. But Papa hid a bunch of stuff behind the old diner and a dumpster. He trusted me with the key and said it was for emergencies. But I bet he wouldn't mind you having it.
I bet he wouldn't. Okay, kid. Probably is the
best. You think I didn't know that? I've been hiding in this place for days. There's an old porta shelter next to the diner near my house. Those stupid things will never get me in there. I'll head over there and wait inside. Hurry back.
Okay, sounds like a really crappy plan. Whatever. Fucking on play radio. Kill things. Nuka-Cola gives me the energy I need to murder raiders out in this wastelands. Oh, good. Right off the bat. I'm taking all your money. You don't know I'm here, and I'm gonna steal your food. Lock your door. Laser pistol? Fuck yeah. Don't mind if I do. Apparently, and I'm sure this isn't news for anybody, but all of this scavenging that you do in this game, I got it, I know how to do this. All the scavenging you do in this game, it's gonna be upped big time in the fourth Fallout, as we'll be using a lot of that stuff to build shelter, you know, build your own home and everything like that, and that's just aces with me. I'm so stoked for that. Got the food. Because I was already, you know, it's like I already, just out of habit, collect half of this stuff. Even though, honestly, half of the stuff that you can build with schematics and everything, I don't use. I don't use a lot of it. I don't need it. But it's just fun. That crafting element to the game just adds so much. So if I'm going to be able to scavenge for things that I'll actually get a big usage out of, like defenses and different cool upgrades for my house, I'm going to be into that. That's going to be a lot of fun. You know I'm here.
Hello! Capital Wasteland, this is Three Dog, ow, coming to you loud and proud.
Oh, yeah.
Lunchtime, children.
I like that. Never mind, I just got shot in the head a couple of times, just gotta walk it off.
Crazy things going on out there in the Capital Wasteland, but this one just might beat them all. I've been getting some scattered reports that a couple of costumed kooks have been battling for control of the settlement called Canterbury Commons. One of these wackos seems to be assisted by a robot.
You like that, huh? Did you like that?
Everything seems to be the same nutty scene. The scuffle's ending in a stalemate. So if your travels take you to Canterbury Commons, keep your head down and your assault rifle loaded.
We are absolutely going to Canterbury Commons, by the way. That is such a funny quest.
This is Three Dog, and you're listening to Galaxy News Radio. We're Radio Free Wasteland, and we're here for you. Up next, we've got a public service announcement. Listen up, children. This stuff's important. Don't feed the Yagwai. Now,
getting good at shooting people in the head. I get lots of practice. Oh shit.
It's go time.
Jesus Christ. I'm the hero, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not as bad as those guys are. Yeah, morality is kind of a gray thing around here. If all you do is blow people's heads off, like, I blow people's heads off, but it's not like I take their decapitated corpses and use railroad spikes to attach them to a wall in an abandoned supermarket. Like, I'm not crazy. That's how the morality meter works around here. The ING, it's gotta be. There we go. Now Now this part's fun. I like doing this. Let's see if I got enough to get this robot to kill for me. Just clear out the rest of the place. Tip for you. Start over if you need to. This is honestly worth it, I promise. Dried, that's four out of them. Got it. Okay. Run maintenance routine. So out he comes. Grab some
floating for.
Yeah, you go awesome. Out there and hang out with running everybody. Default office protocol.
Airborne. Daily agenda. Airborne.
Yeah.
Security.
I love that stuff. So I'll just raid this place.
Stand back.
You go and kill those assholes.
Greetings, fellow office employee.
Hello.
Please present your valid ID.
Oh crap, I need an ID. Crap.
Warning. Scan failure. Please present ID for exit of building.
A lot of good stuff in here.
Intruder alert. Prepare to be forcibly.
Oh boy. Alright, let me grab these last ones. Ah, crap. I'm gonna drop something. Okay. Pretty much full. We got the medicine, we got the food.
Somebody open up that. Hang on.
That means we can leave.
Right here.
Really. Really. And then the robot will probably keep them occupied, although I guess I'll have to shoot them. This is not moving very fast. Jesus Christ! Alright. He's got a machine gun. It's, yeah. Okay.
Oh!
Let's get the fuck out of here.
Right?
I did a good job. Believe in me.
Don't know why.
Okay, so we have officially finished the first chapter of Moira's book. We know that we gotta go kill some monsters out in a different neck of the woods. I'd say we're off to a pretty good start, ladies and gentlemen. So, this has been fun. We're gonna keep doing this one in anticipation of glorious Fallout 4 coming out later this year. I will see you tomorrow. I am Phil the Conquistadork. Like, comment, subscribe, all that other good junk. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye now.